Hey everyone, Kelsey here, and today I'll be walking you through the iFixit rundown, where we fill you in on everything we've been up to this month. We've been busy with teardowns this month, starting with the Xbox One S. With only a few tools needed to take the whole console apart, new to this one was the SATA 3 drive upgrade, improved vibration dampening on the optical drive mount, and we even spotted a cute little mini Master Chief protecting the optical disk drive bracket. And once inside, a clean, no-nonsense modular design, allowing many of the internal components to be easily replaced, the Xbox One S scored an 8 out of 10 on our repairability scale. The OSVR HDK2 was the next VR device on our teardown table. This OSVR sports circular lenses similar to those in the older Oculus Rift HDK2. But the lenses aren't Fresnel like the other devices we've seen lately. One of the biggest improvements to this OSVR set are the two 1080p OLED displays made by AU Optronics. If you have an older HDK, don't worry. Screen upgrade kits are available online at the OSVR store. The OSVR HDK2 scored an admirable 9 out of 10 on our repairability scale. And last but not least, the Galaxy Note 7. In the Note 7, you'll find a newly designed S Pen that won't get stuck backwards in your phone, along with iris scanning technology and sealing gaskets surrounding the modular headphone jack. The Note 7 scored a 4 out of 10 on our repairability scale. On the upside, the sealing gaskets contribute to the Note 7's IP68 water-resistant rating. Modular components and improved cable routing means many components can be replaced independently, but front and back glass make for double the crackability, and due to the curved screen, replacing the front glass without destroying the display will be nearly impossible. Over on our blog, you'll find a story about Dina Amin. We found Dina on Instagram, where she makes teardown videos as part of an ongoing project she calls Tinker Fridays. Tinker Friday began as a hobby where Dina picked up discarded objects, made an educated guess as to how she thought they worked, and then took them apart. Dina hopes that her videos will inspire people to crack into their own devices, and believes that maybe if more people saw what was inside their gadgets, they might not be so afraid to fix them. As you saw in last month's rundown, Zack from JerryRigEverything spent some time with us, and one of the things he did on his visit was try to find out the best way to remove shattered glass on an iPad. After many attempts with metal spudgers, razors, eye openers, and even dry ice, we think we found the best way to do it. Our phones are some of the most abused pieces of electronics, getting tossed around in our purses, backpacks, or bent in our back pockets. Don't get caught investing in a wimpy phone. Zack from JerryRigEverything will fill you in on what will survive and what won't with his bend and scratch tests. Does your iPhone 6 or 6 Plus have a gray flickering bar at the top of the display and an unresponsive screen? Your phone may be showing signs of touch disease. Jessa Jones, owner of iPad Rehab, filled us in on the issue, and every board repair specialist we've spoken to told us that the problem is very common, some seeing up to 100 iPhone 6s a month with symptoms of touch disease. Apple has yet to recognize this as a valid issue, leaving many consumers out of luck and paying out of pocket for potential manufacturing defects. But as of this week, a class action lawsuit has been filed against Apple over the issue. If your phone is showing signs of the disease, don't bother trying to replace the screen. The problem lies in the two touchscreen controller chips, or the touch IC chips, on the logic board inside the phone. Apple's repair geniuses aren't equipped to make specialized repairs to the logic board in-house, so you'll find no cure for the touch disease with them. Your best bet for an out-of-warranty phone will be with a skilled third-party micro-soldering specialist. These specialists can fix phones with symptoms of touch disease, and they can do it for less than the cost of a new logic board or a phone replacement. September will be a busy month for us, with Apple teardowns and so much more. You don't want to miss out, so be sure you're subscribed to our YouTube channel, follow us on Twitter @iFixit, and give us a like on Facebook at facebook.com/iFixit.